Today I want to show you an update to my emergency bag that I keep inside of my vehicle. But first I want to show you this axe. Talk about this survival tactical knife. And it's great for camping and hunting. At least that's what it's designed for. It's a heavy duty axle. Comes with a sheath. Apparently it actually comes with a saw, a knife, and a fire starter. I haven't even seen the saw in here yet, but anyway, just to give you a look, here's the main part, there's a sheath for the axe. Oh, I see. Okay. Maybe you can use this part for like a hammer. I can figure out how to put it together. This appears to be the bottom part. This is a fire starter. You can unscrew this. Take this off. Oh, cool, there's a compass right here. I didn't even notice that. It's a compass right here. This is actually a knife and a saw. So you put this right here, screw it into place, and you got yourself a knife, saw. Put this in place. There you go. You have yourself a multi-tool. What do you guys think? All right, I want to break down my emergency bag into sections, just to give you an idea of what are some good things to put inside of the bag, or at least some of the things I would consider. Okay, it's mostly medical, basic utilities, and food. So you have an emergency medical kit right here with solution to deal with cuts, at least reduce the likelihood of infection. Some basic hygiene, sanitary stuff. Some gauze and bandages. Roll. Maxi pads. Some waterproof tape. Even some wipes. Personal hygiene wipes. You'll be surprised how important that is in an actual emergency. Now this is some sutures. Some stuff I gotta learn a little bit more about. Some mini sutures. That's if the situation gets even more serious, but probably not going to be using that. Here are some foods, some items I actually like for sure. White flatbread slice. I like to put cheese on there. These are MREs, meals ready to eat. Beans, you know, even if I don't have a heater, I can go ahead and heat this up or go ahead and eat it. Sweet and sour chicken and bread. All right, the basic utilities. This section right here. Scissors I'm going to need in case I have to cut some clothes or something. These are actually stormproof matches right here. A little container. And this section right here, this is like the instant section. Stuff I would need like immediately. For example, a quick clot, gauze, a multi-tool. Something I might need pretty quickly. Light source. Flashlight, glow stick. Another important thing to have are gloves. You gotta protect yourself if you're dealing with wounds. Narcan is also an option for some people. Have a Swiss compress bandage in this section right here. So, in the main section, I know I wanna put, well, at least in this section right here, I know I want to put this emergency medical kit right there in the same area. Chest seal. I'm going to put the sliced bread right there. along with the cheese. I have Backpacker's Pantry, this Alfredo, chicken Alfredo. I'm gonna stuff this right in here. Probably less likely to use this, so I'm gonna put this in the back, on the main compartment. But I'm probably gonna need this. This is stuff I'm gonna use for later on. So I'm also put this in the main compartment. Put these gloves in my bag as well. And something that's designed to suppress fire and stop it pretty quickly. Really, might be a really good option to put inside your bag. Now, one of the things I have to make sure I do is I gotta make sure I don't overstuff it to the point where if there is an emergency, I can't really get in here and grab what I need. So I should be able to pull everything that I need out of the bag without too much resistance. Final little test, make sure things are working right. I like to keep the zippers at the top so it's easier to really grab it. By the way, I have a little holster with a tourniquet outside the bag. So it's actually right here. So if somebody goes down, I can just pull it out like that. Again, you want to leave yourself with more room than you think you actually need. You don't want to stuff it to the point where it's not that useful. Now here's a real test. These are the compartments I tend to overstuff. Pretty happy with it. And it doesn't interfere with my concealed carry. All right, shout out to Eva and Brian. Ran into some people. Well, Eva, she says she watches my YouTube videos, and her husband Brian also watches. So, hey guys, it's always fun running into people who have actually seen my YouTube channel. It's always fun. You know, I'm always surprised because sometimes I'll be at work, or sometimes I'll just be chilling at a restaurant or whatever, and I run into people. It's good to know that some people, you guys enjoy what I do, and I definitely enjoy it as well. Man, I never knew this area was right here. All the times I came here, I never really noticed that this place is right here. Hey,